360 video is an interactive video format that lets the user look around in any direction by changing the viewing angle during playback. The viewing angle can be controlled by using a touchscreen, on-screen controls, or by moving the viewing device, such as a mobile device, or by wearing a virtual reality headset. 360 video requires a special video player. YouTube, Facebook, and Vimeo now support 360 videos. VideoStudio lets you edit different types of 360 video: monoscopic equirectangular, single fisheye, and double fisheye. Check your 360 camera or footage to see which you have. When you add your footage to the timeline, VideoStudio 2018 will show the raw 360 camera footage. You can click the 360 icon in the preview pane to preview your footage, as you would see it on your device or 360 video player. To preview single or dual fisheye, you'll first need to convert it to equirectangular format. Just right-click on the footage and select 360, single fisheye or dual fisheye to equirectangular. You will then be able to preview your footage with the 360 icon. Sometimes you want to be in control of the view that your viewers see, and with VideoStudio you can export 360 video as a standard, non-interactive video, with the camera panning around to your direction. To do this, right-click the clip in the timeline and select 360, followed by your footage type to standard. In my case, it's equirectangular to standard. The window on the left shows the 360 footage, and the panel on the right is the output. We can drag either panel. And as we do, keyframes are created, tracking the camera movement. We can drag the keyframes around to fine-tune the camera movement. When we're happy, just click OK. The project has now been converted to a standard video format, with the camera movement now fixed. To undo these changes and go back to editing a 360 project, right-click the clip again and select 360, reset 360 video. We can add titles to 360 footage just like standard footage by using a titles template. Customize the text by double-clicking the text in the preview pane. Then right-click the titles clip and select 360 video, insert as 360. We can then animate the text position around the 360 video as we want it. Let's say we want this text to anticipate the corners the car will take, then zoom off into the distance. First, we'll drag the camera, then drag the scrubber forwards in time, and change the text position parameters again. VideoStudio automatically creates keyframes for this movement. As the road straightens up, we'll scrub to the end of the clip and make the text zoom into the distance. VideoStudio automatically makes another keyframe just in front of the one you add to make the text animation quick and snappy. But if you want a smoother animation, just delete these extra keyframes. When you're happy, press OK to go back to your project. If you're creating an immersive 360 project for VR or some other application, you'll want to include some music to heighten the experience. This clip of the car already has some sound from the wind and noise of the car. but we can add music by clicking the Media tab and selecting some of the royalty-free music from Scorefitter Music Library. Or click the Auto Music icon, audition some music, and when you're happy with your selection, add it to your timeline. To export your project, you have a few options. To export the video as a 360 video, check the Same as Project Settings checkbox. Or select a 360 compatible export profile, such as MPEG-4 AVC 360 resolution. To export your video as a standard, non-360 video, remember you first have to right-click the clip in the timeline and select 360, followed by your footage type to standard. Then keyframe where the camera is pointing. You can then export the resulting standard video project in the usual way. Thank you.